Hello, everyone. So this is the PBE, and they released Warwick's rework today. I have a video up going over some of his abilities and things, but my recording software kind of cropped the video so that you can't see, like, you know, the stuff down here, the mini-map or anything. So I'm just going to do a regular game. This is a bot's game. I'm just testing him out in the jungle. I didn't have him in the jungle. I didn't have Ghost for his alt to test out, so this is what we're just gonna do. And I should have queued when I needed health, but I'll be able to do it again here. So his Q, for people who don't know or didn't see the other video, his Q heals for a percentage of the damage that you do. Which one do I want to add? For the jungle, I think I'm going to go E. So with E, I take significantly less damage, and then it fears when you reactivate or 2 seconds later, 2.5 seconds later. So quick overrun. You have his passive, which gives bonus magic damage. Starts out at 10. You get 2 per level. At 50%, if he is below 50%, he heals for the same amount. If he's below 25%, that amount triples. And his Q is a bite. If you hold on to it, it will lock onto a target and leap to him, doing a percentage. It always does percentage damage, and it'll heal him for 30%. And that scales up to, I think it's like 80% or something, 75%. Then his W is a passive. His attack speed is increased against targets that are below 50%. He senses low champions globally. And he gains movement speed towards them when he's out of combat. These bonuses triple when they are below 20%. When you activate it, he senses all targets, and the nearest one is bloodhunted. And then while he's not hunting someone, the cooldown is increased or decreases quite quickly. So it has 108 second cooldown. So then his E, Primal Howl, is a AoE that gives him damage reduction for 2.5 seconds. And then when he howls, it fears everyone for 1 second. And then his ultimate is a leap, which is based off of his movement speed. So this is why I got Ghost. So the distance of it is based off of your movement speed. So it's 2.5 seconds worth of movement speed in one direction. And then he will suppress the champion for 1.5 seconds, dealing a bunch of damage, doing on-hit effects 3 times, and heals for 100% of all the damage he does. So I'm going to activate my E. And there's my Q. It's not the locked on one. I'll do the locked on one to the next one. So that's a locked on one, and it makes him leap behind him. But you don't have to. You can just auto-click it, and he will just chomp on the target, getting the percentage damage and healing. So let's go get ourselves this here. Now you can see his mana costs are pretty high. Look at this. Look at this. This lag on the server. I've been having this on live, too. And I'm not the only one. Ooh. I don't have a lot of mana to heal off of. We'll just smite that. There we go. So they do suggest getting Sheen on him, because the on hit, and because of the mana. So I'm going to go with this build. I'm going to try to do magic hit or AP. See how it works out. Because like, so this is AD, and this is AD, but that's it. I mean, everything else is magic. Someone is low. Let's see if I can get. That's good. Oh, there's two that are low. There's three that are low. Okay, he's not low anymore. He's still low. I was hoping the leap would wow, he hit really hard. I was hoping the leap would heal me because he was low and it'd give me triple bonus damage and stuff against him. Not didn't work out. I can see how getting Tiamat is good on him. Oh, they don't have Sheen listed here. They just have the Icicleburn Gauntlet. Your team has destroyed. But yeah, let's get this. And I can get the attack speed. We're good there. Still someone. There's two that are still. Rampage. I wish I could tell who they are, though. Oh, they're up. They're double up at base. Kill. So that's how the blood scent works. You can see. I'm also way low on damage, that's why. Or a level. Ooh, my goodness. Yeah, I was talking and setting up. I'm behind. That's all right. We got, man, this is almost annoying me, the amount of people that are low and stuff. Now, you can't leap over walls with your Q, which is a bit kind of frustrating. I was hoping that I could. Got the ult now, so that's good. Oh my god, let's see if we can find anyone with this blood scent. Because, like, I can see them. Nope, they're gone. Let's pick up this here. Well, I cleared that pretty quickly. Oh, it's because I'm doing percentage health, that's why. Alright, no one is low.
Shut down. All the blood you spilled brought me here.
They're just higher level than me. Don't have it yet. We'll get some some lifesteal from that.
You killed Warwick, that left the beast.
Still don't have boots yet either. Yeah, I really thought I was actually going to be able to kill him before Zeriel killed me. Those boots not having boots are hurting. Just farm. Yeah, they're two levels higher than me. Plus the amount of gold. I'll try out, yeah, I'll see about doing dragon. See how a solo dragon is behind, but I'll, you know, oops. So someone's low. That's why you want. I can see how you want. She. Because as I use my Q, yeah, I can definitely solo this. See what we can find here. Who is low? Not anyone in range. I saved him with my fear. Jesus, these spots just won't quit. Whoa. That was a leap behind one of the little guys. Who is low? Rampage. Yeah, that worked out okay. Pick up red. No one is low anymore. Someone is now. Shut down. Wish I could tell how low they are. Your team has an ally has been slain. Just don't have it. Yeah, I'm still two levels behind him. go for always movement speed, attack speed. Yeah, he doesn't do, I don't know. He's not as tanky with just attack items as he was on live, it feels. Oh, I haven't upgraded my W. So your W gives you bonus attack speed against low targets, and that's good. Someone is low. Up here? Out of range. Let's see. Let's pick up this and we'll see if we can kill Ray's. I highly doubt we can. But you know, I may be able to. Good. I interrupted his ult with my ult. His mana costs are pretty high. I find that interesting with a lot of other champions that they've done, did not have these high mana costs. There we go. I was able to chase down a Swain.
An enemy has been slain.
So someone is pretty low over this direction. I don't know if it's... Yeah, it was... Darius. See, I'm getting caught up. Yeah, I'm getting caught up. Let's go see about Darius. Swain's there. Oh, Darius is low. Can I leap to him? God dang it. How come? I've got bonus movement speed. What the hell? What does he have? I mean, seriously. Not a lot. He's in trouble. I'm dead.
Okay, I don't have any resistances to Swain. Oh, yeah, we'll pick that up first. That's right, I said I was going to do the AP. I'm going to try that. Attack speed. Though, I mean, nothing scales with AP. It really doesn't. Actually, no reason to go it. I wanted to see if we could, but... So who is... Oh, they are. Alright, I can do this. I can do this. Ah, she got him. Alright, these guys are low, so let's go this way. Oh no, they're not low at all.
Vengeance is only a step behind you.
I'd love for him to come within turret range.
An enemy has been slain.
Who am I? Who is low? Let's see. My alt range is not great.
Enemy killing spree.
Swain is not the one that it wants me to. I was hoping to ult him, but that works. Someone's way low over here. Just look at the mana costs. I mean, he is low. Let's go. Let's go. Nope, it's not E. Who the hell is it? Well, look at E anyway. Oh, bastard! Oh, well, that worked. So he's feeling tankier now. Yeah, I mean, now I'm higher level than them. Be able to get the Blood of the Rune King. So this should cause my on hit, should cause my passive to trigger twice. What else? It says that, oh, well, definitely, let's get this. We need that mana. So who am I hunting here? Oh. So as you can see, the ring gives me the range on my alt. I killed him, so... Yeah, we're gonna win this here. I wanted to try to get full build, so... Let's only try to go for kills. Really annoying. It actually makes me like want to go to combat. You know, it's like someone's there, someone's gonna die. I can get it. I can get it. You know. Ah, the turret. But I got ye. I guess the turret wasn't the main damage on there, but. This gives me 7% movement speed. This gives me mana and damage. This gives me attack speed.
Has destroyed a turret. An ally has been slain.
This will give me some clear.
An ally has been slain.
I don't want it to end too quickly, but it's going to end here. They're not going to be able to clear out two inhibitors worth of minions. Here, with this setup, I'm going to go hit dragon. So I wish I could see where they are. I mean, having the blood trails is, you know, but it's like, I don't know where they are. Alright. Let's see. I've got an okay amount of lifesteal and stuff. Let's see at level 16 if I can take on Baron before they end this. I'm gonna say no, I don't have enough lifesteal. Yeah, get out of here. Whoa, I'm dead. Yeah, I don't have enough lifesteal yet. Which is, I mean, even with it being triple. Huh.
An ally has been slain.
I'm not using this at all. Let's give me some cooldown reduction.
An ally has been slain. Has been slain. The enemy's inhibitor is respawning. Ace.
So who's dying? It's gonna be Yi. I could maybe do Yi. Maybe Swain is there and. Oops. So now, the activation portion of... See, that didn't work. So I activated this. He briefly senses all enemy champions, and the nearest one is bloodhunted for 8 seconds. Did you see any blood trail? I didn't see any blood trail. So... You know, granted, cooldown is almost done again.
Your team has destroyed.
Yeah, look how fast that cooldown goes down. There we go. Now someone's blood hunted. What's interesting is so the ult is a skill shot, yeah, so it was the first champion I ran into. I was trying to go for Yi, but I landed on, I don't know who I landed on. Was it Annie? No, that's my guy, so it was Swain, it was, yeah, I think I landed on Swain. I don't have ability to power, so yeah, Wit's End would be the way to go. Or Phantom Dancer for the bonus movement speed. Yeah, we'll go Phantom Dancer. Clear this out. Dang it. Thought I had them all that were... There's no reason to ult him. Let's go bot lane. Back. The fear, I think, just missed him. Well, let's blast yourselves over the wall here. Oh, dragon's not here, what? Oh, you can see the little, there's a little Warwick head above them when they are below certain ranks. I don't want to win this, though. How did we... Oh, we must have had another inhibitor down. Anyway, so that's a... You can see more of what's going on with him. I'm still not familiar. I mean, I'm not really familiar with Warwick's playstyle on live. So his new playstyle, I'm just trying to understand how things are working out. I was expecting to get more healing, especially when I ulted someone. Because on live, that's what happens. You can just, you know. Now, granted, I didn't get Spirit Visage. That's another item. I don't know if it was even in the suggested build. It may have been. But Spirit's Visage would be really good on him. Anyway, yeah, so this is the Warwick Rework. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share, subscribe. I'll be putting up more videos here in the future. Thanks.